made a definitely great players of their own. So, okay. Game one. Fuzziness bringing out Jigglypuff.
It's really important for the red team to stay sort of separated. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of rests, and you don't want to be too close. And the worst thing that can happen is like a double rest on the team.
Yep.
It's pretty hard to come back from.
Do you think there's a thought or a reason behind this pick, the Jigglypuff pick, instead of the Captain Falcon that we're used to seeing Fuzziness with?
I mean, hard to say, but it's always hard for a Fox to really react to Jigglypuff's up throws. I mean, you've seen HBox performing on Armada several times. In teams when you're not aware that you're getting grabbed because everything happens at the same time. So you can get a lot of cheap wrists with Jigs on a Fox, so maybe that's part of the equation.
Yeah, I can see that. Thing is, we know, like, it's been established that Puff versus Fox, it's in Fox's favor, right? But I feel like in teams, when you're with a partner and...
Oh, look at that.
That was actually very nice. That's kind of nullified. When Fox doesn't have the space to, like, shut down Puff as much. Which makes Puff just, you know, great character in teams. There he goes. Off the top. The trademark up throw upper. The Puff killer. Humpei, I think... Is Humpei playing...
The Fox?
Is he the Fox?
No, he's Falco.
Oh yeah, he's Falco. It says so up there, but I'm not sure.
Are we gonna trust that?
I guess. They both play Falco, right? In singles.
Yeah, no, I think Humpei is playing Fox. Alright.
Okay.
Anyway, it seems like the both teams enjoy sort of splitting up and play more like one against one. Close match, real close, either way. This probably one of the more important stocks.
Yeah.
After that, you really have to be quick and get something out against the 2v1, and that can really seal the deal in this match.
That was a crucial edge guard to get on Prof that Fuzziness managed to keep the red team out, so they couldn't really edge guard him, which brought him back. And
that's a mess up.
He's gonna let. No, he dies off the top. Okay.
Can't get up.
And suddenly the game's in KaliW and Humpei's favor here.
But with Jigs on the team and the rest.
Yep, you never know what's
always possible to come back.
Edgeguard? Yeah, he does. He trades for it. Which is the worth. So one stock apiece, everyone.
Ooh!
Great back
here. Now it's real interesting.
1v1, let's go.
Probably gonna see Jigglypuff go into the edge and just wait for Falco. Yeah.
Yeah. This is some hard laser camping right here. He wants to play it as safe as possible.
Yeah, which he should. I mean,
yeah.
You're a tournament. You want to play for to win. No point not using the gun with Falco
exactly.
When you have it.
Exactly. This is a very tricky matchup for Falco. I feel like, and you have to definitely make use of that laser. That pew pew. Finally a hit confirmed from someone.
I mean, it's easy to get frustrated and just
rush in to
finish the match because you feel if that guy has more percent that you sort of, this is your match, you deserve to win.
Just like he did now. He I think he got a bit impatient there, but if just lasering. Anything can really happen here. Oh no. Oh, okay, he lives. So anything right now is basically going to kill Puff. A strong back air, a down tilt. So he definitely has to be careful, but then again, that Puff factor, it's always there. A gimp, a wrist, it can always happen. I feel like Humpei is getting a... Is that it? No, he's living. It's good DI. This is a nail biter right here. I think it's so funny when there's a 1v1 and the teammates, they're just watching and like sweating.
It's so risky for Falco to get anywhere near the stage.
There we go.
So yeah, real good that he held the center stage. That was really the best thing he could do.
Absolutely. He actually played that very well, except for a tiny, like, almost SD there, which he survived anyway with the up B. Very patient play by Humpe. Humpe, whatever.
I mean, you say a lot of time when HBug's playing that he's also very patient and makes use of the edge. And some people are criticizing that, but yep. I mean, it's a tournament, so.
Exactly.
Play to win.
Exactly.
All right, bigger stage. It's going to be harder to kill Jigglypuff. The space is, with all the shines and the edge guard you can actually use, I think it's not going to be that much of a difference. So definitely in the green team's favor this stage.
I agree. The Puff is going to live longer. But, oh, there goes Cal W. So, do you agree with this counter pick?
Yeah, for sure. Like I said, Jigs love this stage. And in case it's going to be another 1-1 or something like that, I mean, it's really English team's favor.
Yeah, ooh, grab wrist.
Weak wrist.
Ooh, another one. He just gets him right off the recovery.
Finally, we haven't seen that many rests so far from Fussiness.
I think only one in the last game. Ooh, he's like...
But that edge guard.
That was nice. And this game just turned very quickly. A rest and edge guard, the game. Is, he actually gets a prof off the stage. Everybody survives. Let's see if he can come back. Yeah, he does.
I'll let both of them back in.
They're both back. They're going to try to regain control.
Kind of critical.
Prof playing patiently off the ledge, waiting for Fuzziness to get back while he's recovering. Let's see. Can he get this edge guard? Cal W makes it back. Prof goes high.
Red team still has most stage control, I would say.
It's very nice.
They have a hard time to kill the green team.
Oh, nice save. Very nice save. Yep, they're doing very well. Like, every time Prof is off stage, Fuzziness is there, like, covering the ledge and not letting them edge guard at all. Prof comes back for the first stock, and there goes Random. I mean, Fuzziness. Ooh, this is a shine game. Good angle, and there he goes. Okay.
And the table has turned once again.
So fast this game. Oh no, okay.
Yeah, with those percent, I would say this is as close as it can be.
Very true. Oh, there's a rest. And there he goes. And suddenly it turned again. That's Puff.
Impossible, yeah. But... The second he gets grabbed by Fox, it's over.
It's over.
So you probably want to try to focus on the Jigglypuff, but at the same time you can't kill it. And you're forced to try to gimp the Fox. So this is an almost impossible task.
Okay, he gets back there. Oh, the rest misses. He's going to wake up right away. He's actually doing well. He's like, he's really giving them a fight.
Ooh. Another stage with lower ceiling. That could actually help Fox kill his opponents. It might have worked, but Dreamland.
Oh my god, that was Prof. Cali W can actually make this comeback right now. He's being... No rest.
You can see that Fossman is nervous. That
yep.
Sloppy edge guarding.
He didn't manage to do it last game, and I think the nerves are getting to him a bit. Nice nair. Oh my god, this is going to be so sick. Cali W, the hometown hero.
Yeah, Cali W needs to rack up a lot more damage before he can KO Jigglypuff.
Yep. So using that laser to his advantage.
Not that much laser, but maybe he's a bit afraid of using it.
Thing with laser... Oh, Cali!
Look at that! They
wow,
took
what
it.
A comeback! Cali W! Wait, is that it?
I heard it was only best of three the whole day, but...
It should be, right?
Yeah.
Best of three?
Unless there's a gentleman's agreement.
Where did I ask him?
All right.
Really? Isn't this the same losers side as Zoler and Randomness.
I think so, yeah.
And that was only a best of three.
I'm pretty sure the staff told me earlier that it was only best of three the whole day in doubles.
Okay. Maybe we should...
But, oh well, I mean, gentleman's agreement, they're already playing.
All right. Okay. Oh, wait, he's switching here.
And we don't have that many matches left tonight, and I guess streams want to watch some more Melee.
That's true. Fair enough. How many matches are left after this? I think there's like one or two, or maybe more.
Something actually. Like that.
Because the top eight is tomorrow, everyone. You should.
All right, so Fuzzman changed to Fox.
Fox, okay. Not happy with the puff. Didn't work out in the last stock scenarios as well as they would have hoped, so they're trying something else. Not the Captain Falcon still, though. Which I guess makes sense. Against the Spaceys, he's gonna have a hard time.
I mean, and like the first stock or two, after a team changed characters and gonna play completely different,
yep.
You sort of need to size up the opponent once again, because you need to change your playstyle.
Would you say if Kale, W, and Humpe, if they win this, if they take this set, would you count that as an upset?
Nah, I mean, as I said before, I was pretty sure it's going to be a close set,
yep.
But I thought that Fuzz and Prof were the favorites. Still not surprised if they would win, even if I maybe wouldn't have bet on it.
Okay,
before
that's fair enough. But, right now... Oh, okay, so two stock lead here for green team. Double Fox, maybe what the answer... Wow. He dies off the side B, yeah. So Double Fox was maybe the answer they were looking for. Yeah, they're in pretty comfortable lead right now. But as we said, anything can happen. Last game and the first game, green team were in the lead a lot of times and still managed to...
It's correct.
Yeah.
It seems like the green team has the most stage control.
Wait, which Fox is who? I'm not sure, so anyway.
Alright, Fuzzman is Goku.
Alright. The Goku attack. There goes Humpe.
Oh, look at that spacing!
Are they gonna get this edge guard? No, we're well recovered, and also Humpe comes to save it, his teammates.
The synergy in the green team is so much better now when Fuzzman switched to Fox. They have an easier time to combo with each other and just save each other. And
yep.
I think Jigglypuff's lack of speed didn't work out for them.
It was a big factor, you think? So, I have no idea if Fuzzness has been playing a lot of Puff earlier in this tournament or if it was picked tailored for this matchup, but this is working out well. I mean, the double Fox now, so is that gonna be it? Yeah, four stock. Fuzziness and Professor
Crow. Really good team edge guard from the green team.
Yeah,
really covered the most options, and they know which role they had and their team partner.
Very well played. I mean, The center stage control that whole game was immaculate by the green team. I mean, they were always in control. They never looked like they were flustered. But they're still down. So we'll see where what the counter pick is going to be and if there's going to be any more character changes here. Let's see. I feel like a Yoshi's game would be fun in a matchup like this. Not the most popular double stage, though, I feel like.
I think most teams just find it too small. You'll end up hitting your team partner if you aren't careful. But yeah, if you play against Spaceys and you have a Peach on your team, then Yoshi Story is a real good option, actually.
It is. Fast matches, fast pace. It's a very entertaining stage as well.
Right, FD.
FD. contrary to Yoshi's, this is actually one of the more popular double stages. Very neutral pick. Ooh, green team going in there on the Falco. Nice back throw to back air there by Fuzziness and Prof.
Fuzziness and Prof is like almost playing like Adam and Sigeto. It's like one half the left side of the stage, another one the right side. And just try to help each other out still, but okay. They have their sides. The red team, on the other hand, sort of always want to be closer to each other to be able to assist each other even more than the green team.
So would you say their green team's play style is sort of like kind of a 1v1, and then you help your teammate as soon as you can with the speed of the characters with the double fox?
Sort of. Like you see here, Fuzziness just took out Kel W and Prof. To the center stage, and he knew that Fuzziness is gonna edge guard and can take care of the other one.
Fuzziness air dodges off the stage, unfortunate SD. How's it? Okay, it's pretty good.
With the red team's playstyle, this stage does not really give them any favors.
You don't think so?
It's a bit too big, and the green team likes to split up.
Yeah.
But still, red team are doing really well.
Ooh, nice save there. Nice laser save by Humpe. See if he's gonna survive this. Ooh, nice. Down smash to back air on basically everyone.
On a turn of table. It's so important when you actually get your opponent from the stage that you edge guard. Yep. In teams, it's so common that players just rush back to center stage to try to help your teammate or assist a combo and not actually assure that you're edge guarding the opponent.
Oh. Humpe catches Kalidabli with that back air, but he gets back. This whole game, I feel like, has been like edge guard situations all over the place, and like
yeah, trading places.
Yeah.
Who's the one on the edge?
Ooh, man, look at Prof's stocks. He's been holding on to those, doing a great job with that as well. There it goes, his second stock. But still, I mean,
and that was so critical to the whole game.
Yeah, because if they would have gotten. Okay, this is gonna be difficult. This is gonna be very hard. Yeah, that's it. 2-2. We're going into game 5, which is always good. Seeing a game 5.
For sure.
Yep. This is gonna be nail biter right here. Let's check the bracket real quick. See if any other games have been played. Looks like Zolar and Randoness are going up against Blade and Abate. I have no idea who Blade is.
I mean, neither actually.
Yeah, but Abate, you know. The famous Luigi that
we have all. A lot of Luigi players at this tournament.
Yeah, actually, that's true. I've seen a couple. I think the character's picking up a bit more popularity in the later days. I mean, some would argue that... What year was it? Was it 2014? That was the year of Luigi? He's coming back.
Yeah, maybe. I don't recall that.
They have like this thing. I think 2015 was...
Chic?
They have this thing everywhere in the community. I don't know. I think Luigi had his year.
Well, like the Chinese Zodiac?
Exactly.
All right.
Just like that. It's like based on picks and results and just like... It's for fun. I like Luigi, he's a fun character. He's not fun to play against, but it's very cool.
Seems like they're going to go back to final, is that it?
Looks like it. They're having
some hesitation from the red team.
So, battle. I don't know, I think, as you said, that maybe they should try a bit going somewhere. Okay, Pokemon Stadium, it's better. Got some platforms, transformations that might favor them.
Two teams with spaces. Goes real well for both of them.
Wait, have they? They haven't been on this stage yet, right?
Yeah, I think so.
No, probably not yet. I thought maybe they went back to... No, 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 because they lost on... Oh, never mind. You see, do you think, like, in a situation like that, should they have edgeguarded Fuzziness? Or went double on Prof like they did? Because right now, it came back to bite them in the ass.
I mean, it's so hard to second guess afterwards. Yeah. It's a split decision you have to make.
It is. Just quick decisions all the time in this game. Especially, doubles where you have to make a decision with your partner, which is like... so huge.
This match, we see a lot more that the teams are playing like the red team sort of one. The red team is pretty close to each other. And it works pretty well for them.
It is. Bit of a percent difference here, but pit fights, let's go. This is very close at the moment, honestly. High percents, like, look at Falco, 158. Okay, double edgeguard situation, they both come back. Alright, well done. They almost turned that into their favor. Nice up smash. Oh, he saved him. Alright, slight lead here, but I mean, these percents. Nice up air. There goes some play.
Fuzziness is Prof, I'm sorry. Prof is so lethal near the edge. So many shines.
Exactly.
So accurate.
I never knew.
What a team combo from red team! Look at that.
This is dangerous. Okay, you made it back. Did they get. Just holding on to this that stock. I never knew Fuzziness even had a Fox.
Oh, you didn't?
I actually didn't know.
Oh, alright.
I just knew him as Captain Falcon. So, still very close. Nice combos there by Hoopa.
Racking up a lot of damage.
Forward smashes Cali W, but he makes it back. Is Hoopa gonna die? No. Nice recovery. They both make it back. Can you get this? The pal there. 2-0. Prof is there right away. There he goes.
It is at this point that the nerves are really starting to kick in.
Exactly. Oh, he actually made it back from that? Okay, so back in.
Now the nerves come into play, and players are doing a lot more mistakes than they usually do.
Yep, definitely. Still, this can go in anyone's
stay alive.
Favor. Yeah, Hoopa really needs to say it.
Oh, look at that.
Shine Spike.
Prof, so efficient with the Shine Spike.
It's very good with those. Let's see if... I mean, they made a 2-rerun comeback in one of the games. They could do it again.
Oh, you should have just hit him with an up smash or F smash.
Yeah,
just
anything.
Didn't touch him.
He just stood there, really. I think, I mean, just as you're saying, the nerves. Oh, nice up smash. Let's see if he can do this. Come on. Ah, great up air. Edgeguard situation.
Oh, edgeguard. That.
Ooh. Air dodge. Both players are so scared right now. You can just see it in their gameplay.
And of course, Cal W just want him near the edge so he can shine in.
It.
But
yeah,
it's not going to fall for it.
Reverse 3-0 to take the set.
And they did it.
Yep. I guess the Fox switch was what they needed. Worked out in their favor, great. So, well played to both teams. Very entertaining set to watch. I think we have a couple of more matches to go. Let's see who's up
next. Was it Randomness and Solar is going to play now against Abate and...
Blade. I'm not sure if they're playing right away.
Oh, I see Randomness walking towards stage.
All right. That's going to be fun. See you, Luigi.
All right, last set for today.
Already? That sucks. I want to see more Grape Smash. But this is going to be a good one, definitely. I mean, a Luigi in teams. Luigi overall is just always fun to watch. And I have no idea who Blade plays, but guess we'll see. Double Fox, definitely gonna limit Luigi's recovery a lot.
Yeah.
It's very difficult for him to get back with from those shines. But, you know, Abate, that's he's a player of another caliber.
That is true. And, of course, we have a couple of good Luigis in Europe, but no one on Abate's level, I would say.
Exactly.
So that's going to be something else.
Arguably the best Luigi in the world together with Eddie Mexico,
yeah.
I would say. And seeing as how well he performed last year, I'd say as of now he's ranked number one in the world. So it's not going to be easy to go against him. Where's... they're not there right yet, right?
No, not yet.
Okay, I want to know who Blade is. They're trying to get him to come to the stage. Holy, look at that. Apparently Blade is another Luigi player. So we're going to see Double Fox versus Double Luigi.
That's going to be pretty interesting.
Very interesting. So, a German Luigi, I believe. Not here quite yet, though. How would you approach a matchup like this, a double Luigi?
If I would play a double Fox team?
Oh yeah, I guess, or generally just, how do you go up against the... I've never even played a Luigi in teams, to be honest.
If you just start the team combo route, it's kind of easy to team combo Luigi because it's sort of floaty.
Yeah.
But you gotta be careful because his aerials are so quick that most times it's good to eat once or twice and back off. But two foxes, you're gonna see a lot of shines and try to gimp him, which you should be able to do.
Thing is with the shines, they send Luigi so far away, right? So I guess you could like shine and retreat to your teammates, or just like, because you can't really follow up on any of the shines. It's just like, it's more of a tool in this matchup to get the Luigi away from you, or like, well, in edgeguards as well, but I'm thinking more about in the neutral game on stage. The shine just like sends Luigi so far away that, I don't know, I like to see how they're gonna approach this right now. I wonder who they lost to, the double Luigis. Probably, maybe Armada and Android. Let's see. No.
The people have spoken. 18 against 82.
I believe in
a have a clear favorite here.
So guys, tomorrow we have. Top 100 and something?
28 in singles?
Yeah, exactly. And we have top 8 doubles and also Smash Wii U, which I don't know a lot about, but definitely tune in for those as well. It's going to be great. We have